Hello all. In this video, I would like to share with you my JavaScript solution for the LeetCode challenge implement a trie or a prefix tree. What I will do is first I will explain what a trie is and then we will go together through the implementation. With that being said, let's get started.
A trie or a prefix tree, as the name says it, it is a tree-like data structure that can be used, for example, to quickly find a word in a dictionary. It is efficient because the time complexity for inserting or finding a word is the number of nodes multiplied by the length of the word. If we look on the right side at the graphical representation, we see that each node corresponds to a symbol. By convention, the root node is always represented by an empty string. The other nodes correspond to a letter. We also see that the end of a word is marked with an asterisk. So if we try to identify the words in this trie, we see that we have Roman, Rome, me, and Greek. Now let's look at how a node looks like. In a trie, a node is represented like this. It has the property children, which is of type map, and it has also the property isEnd of type boolean. So if we look at the root node, the children's map for this node will contain the keys R, M, and J, and the values corresponding to these keys will be of type node. So the value corresponding to the key M will be of type node and it will have a property children which will have one key which will be E and the value for that key will be another node which will have the property children an empty map and the property isEnd set to true, because it is the end of a word. To better understand how the trie works, let's see how we add a word inside a trie. So I prepared an animation. I have prepared a list of words that we are going to insert one by one into an empty trie. So the first word we are going to start with is a Roman, and the process is we are going to check the first letter inside the word. If it exists in the trie, we are looking at the first level and we don't find it, so we insert it. The same for O, we are looking at the next level and we don't find it, so we add it. Same for M, A, and then for N, we also mark it as an end of the word. The next word we will look at and we'll try to insert is Rome. So for Rome, the first letter in the word is as well R, and we check in the first level in the tree and it is already there, so we don't add it anymore. The same for O, the same for M, and E, we check at this level in the tree, and we don't find it, so we add it, and we also mark it as the end of the word. Now, the next word is M. So, what could be confusing for some of you, at least it was for me when I first tried to understand how the trie data structure works, like, is do we have to add it in the trie or not? Because for instance we have here M and E. What I didn't understand the first time was that the order of the letters is it corresponds to the order of the nodes. So if we want to check if M exists in the trie, we have to check in the first level of the node. And we see that it does not exist, so we add it in the first level. And then same for E, we check in the second level, it doesn't, we've added it and we've marked it as the end of the word. And also the next example is interesting because it's a particular case. So we have the same situation, we have the first letter M, we already have it in the trie, we don't add it anymore. The same for E, we have it here, we don't add it. But what about the next E? We have to check at this level in the keys of the node E, and we see that it's missing, so we add it here. And also the last letter T, it's not in the keys of the node E, so we add it and we mark it as the end of the word. So you see here that we have two marks for an end of a word inside consecutive letters, consecutive nodes. So you could have a word inside a bigger word. Yeah, so that's how it's represented. And next we have Greek, which is more simple. So G is not in the first level, R is not in the second level, and the children of the node with the key G. Same for E, same for second E, and then we add K. And yeah, that's how we insert words in a trie. I hope this was more clarifying. The next part will be the implementation of this method and another method, basically the solution for the LeetCode problem that we talked about in the beginning. So let's see how that looks like. So let's look at the requirements of the challenge. So the title is Implement a Trie, the number is 208. And it asks us to implement the trie object and the methods insert, which will receive a string and will try to insert it inside a trie. Another method, search, will also receive a string and will return true or false if it finds that string inside a trie, so basically a word. And then another method starts with, which is checking if it finds a prefix, so a start of a word inside the trie. And it will also return true or false. So what I did here, I prefer to use classes instead of the functions that were predefined by LeetCode. And you can see here the node class that you saw in the presentation before with the children as a map, and the flag is end set to false by default. We also have the trie class with the constructor, which initializes the root node with an empty node. And then we have the insert method that we saw in the animation. So what does it do? It goes through each level inside the tree, in the trie, and then it goes through each letter inside the word, and it does some checking. So it's starting with the root node, and then it checks, does the current node children have a key that is the same with the letter, the current letter that we are checking? If it doesn't, then we add it to the children map with the value an empty node, and then we proceed to the next level inside the try. We get the next node inside the children of the current node. We do this for every letter and for every node until we reach the end of the word. When we do that, we also mark this end of the word inside our try. So we set isEnd to true. So that was the insert method, pretty simple. Let's check the search method. So it receives as input also a string, and we check if the string is empty, and if it is, we return false. Then we iterate again through the node. We start through the nodes. We start with the root node, and we iterate through the letters, and we check if the current node contains the key of the current letter. If it doesn't, we return false because we want to have each letter of the word inside a try and in the corresponding order. So we return early false. If not, we continue to the next node and the next letter, and so on until we reach the end of the word. And if we did not return until then, it means we found every letter. But is it really a word? So is it also marked? Is the last letter of the word also marked as an end inside our try? So that's what we return here. If it is, it will return true. If it's not, it will be false. So that's the search method. Then we have a similar method, starts with, which receives another string, which it's called a prefix. And what this method does, it's checking if it finds this beginning of a word inside a try. The method looks very similar to the search until here. So from the start until here. The part that is different is the return method here. So if it's not checking anymore if it's the end of the word inside the try, because it only wants to find the prefix and not the exact word. Yep, so as you can see, I've run this code and it was accepted. Also, my submission was successfully accepted. I really hope this was helpful. I would love to receive some feedback from you, so you can leave it in the comments down below. Next time, I would like to solve another LeetCode challenge, also related to try, so please stay tuned. Until the next time, I wish you all a great one.